Hello everybody, what's up? This is Hikari EXE. We're continuing our playthrough. So, as you can see just from the map, this game has been definitely a game of massive empires. You even have Korea, Ming, Bengal, Delhi, the Ottomans, and Timbuktu. I mean, Tunis, look at this. It's a mass land grab. So, after this game, we're going to play this differently. This is still on 1.15. 1.16 came out yesterday, and I plan on playing that. So we're just going to let the time continue until probably the end, actually. We'll have to see how these things go. Alright, we're moving this way. So yeah, we just had some major wars. I haven't played this in about 2 weeks because... I don't know, I got sick and tired of it, getting my ass beat, basically. That's a nice way of putting it. Oh no, a revolt. Yikes. How is our armies doing? Okay. Probably fight them. Or put them here. Do we have the manpower? Well, we should. Okay. Let's try that out first. Excellent ear. Nice. That is somewhere I should defend. Okay. For a second I thought we were at war. I'm like, oh no. Okay, we're having some frame rate issues. Let's see. There you go. It was like, move please. Are we funding the armies? That's an important question. It looks like we're not. Well, shit. That could be a problem. Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, you bastards! You didn't, did you? Motherfucker! Okay. Okay, whatever. Fine. Fine, 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 fine. I'm trying to heal these guys out. Yeah, I get it. Okay. Move over. That's just lovely. I had no idea. Okay. Oh, and they took a fort. Ah, damn it. Okay. Comes back to game, gets a fort taken. Oh, man. That's rough. Okay, we're gonna move here. Should we attack them? You know what? Let's go for it. I don't see a river crossing, so... come on. Oh yeah, well, we have some imaginary river crossing. We won, nice. Took a heavy casualties, I could speak. Well, we won, nonetheless. 1709. Ethiopia fights internal conflicts. Should really reorganize my YouTube playlist. That's something. Yeah, because after I finish this, I'm going to be taking probably a break from EU4 for a little bit and play something else, like XCOM or just... I don't know. I've been really enjoying XCOM lately. Pretty fun. Okay, at least it's like a level 1 or a level 2 for it. I can live with that. How are our colonies doing? Sweet, we have a nice buffer state over there. Cool. Can we colonize anything? Yeah, we can, but should we? Is that Majapahit? Yeah, okay. I think they won the war because I don't remember it. It was something really stupid. Where's Senegal? Are you still protected with the Ottomans? Yes, you are. They've been protected by the Ottomans for about at least 250 years. So that's lovely. Who are those rebels? Shajar, Sepetus. Oh. You have fun with that. Fighting that massive army of the Ottomans. Oh, this is still annexed. I didn't know that. Well, I should move these guys. Okay, good. Now, if we can move these guys here, that's where we need to move them. Move as many as you can. Just hope we don't get a war declared on us. National decision. No, we took all the loans. All the loans. We're almost there. Yeah, you know, this game does require a lot of strategy, that's a given, but at the same time, it does require a little bit of luck, because battles can go either way. I mean, basically, one battle can decide just the momentum of the war. It's absolutely true. Let us move them back here. Yes. Forget that. Stay. Business is booming. Excellent. Well, see, now we're getting the good events. See, that's how this works. On a unrelated topic, I think one movie that deserves a sequel, just because it's a funny movie, not because it's particularly good or anything, it's just... I don't know, I found amusement was the movie Zombieland. I think that would be an interesting movie to make a sequel of, because, I mean, there are plenty of tropes to just make fun of. I think that would be quite enjoyable, actually. I think it would also do good at the box office, since, I mean, zombies always do well. I mean, unless it's, like, just really bad, like, to the point where it's, like, The Room or something, but... yeah... One thing I'm also going to do for these videos is... I've basically been using these as more of an archive, since I know not a lot of people watch them, but I was thinking about maybe just trying to talk about interesting things. I thought, you know, maybe that will go over well. Perhaps someone will even like it. Just an idea to do. Alright, so let's unfund our army, or at least find a way to... still losing money, eh? Okay. It's because of those damn loans. Well, we could destroy some of the army. I think our priority should be, split in half. Get rid of them. There we go. Okay, that's manageable. How much money are we actually making? Okay, we're making like half a ducat a month. Sweet. Also, I noticed it's a lot harder to move from absolute zero than from a low position, so give them some maintenance. Our country actually seems relatively stable, to be honest. It doesn't... also, we could destroy this fort. That's something we could do, so we don't particularly need it anymore. See, we don't need that. It'll give us a little bit more money. Cool. Some better boats. Yeah, they're definitely encroaching. I'm just waiting for the Ottomans to have a bad year, and then bam, they lose all of that, and then they'll lose this. Because this area especially, very unpredictable. What's their mission? Conquer the last Crusader bastion. They're probably going to try to like conquer this part. I don't think they'll get that far. Just judging by the Ottomans, they spread out too thin. They're going to get their ass kicked if they try that, I think. Maybe not in pure militarily strength, but just funding the damn thing. Are we making any money? Let's see. I mean, are we making enough to hire someone? That's kind of what we should be looking at. National tax modifier, that might help us out. Yeah, 10% is a lot late game since, I mean, shit, you're making so much money at this point, or at least you should be, that it just makes a huge difference. Let's say you're making, I don't know, 10 ducats a month. I mean, 10% of that's what, one ducat? I mean, that's still a pretty decent thing. I mean, you're making 100 ducats, 10, so, you know, it adds up. Ooh. Do I need the stability, or do I need the money? I'll take the money, because why not? Also, we should change from Basra, Gulf of Aden, Alexandria, Constantinople. No, we can't. Crimea. Okay, maybe. Where could we do Indus? I think that would actually be decent. What's this name? Amda Sigon Basaya. I probably botched that really badly, but let's try over here. Yeah, because more of our trade is going to be coming from this area there, since we got a good hold on the Philippines. Low on prestige, but hopefully that'll go up. Convert, should we? Let's do that. It's gonna cost a lot, though. Wait, why do I still have mercenaries? That's a problem. The hell do I have mercenaries? Okay. Oh, yes. Oh, I was confused for a second. I'm like, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Let's look at the religious map mode. We haven't done that. Not bad. Not bad at all. We've increased Coptic over here, but especially we made huge gains over here. We want to win a cultural victory since Islam is doing quite well, but not bad. Not bad at all. That just shows you how much of our country we've lost. It's a shame, really, but these things happen. It's going to take them an arm and a leg to convert that crap, though, probably. Yeah, we can core this stuff now. for all of it. Good. More money, more fun. Still losing a little money, but fabricating claims on us. Damn you, Mutapa. There's Portugal. Spain. Nice. Oh, I'd love it if Spain invades Mutapa. That would be amazing. Spain, go for it, man. Just destroy them.
Yeah, it sounds like there's some thunder outside.
Good thing about being behind is you get easy tech. The Ottomans are only at 24, so in hindsight, we're not really that far behind. Superior units, what is it? Swivel, okay, so. Yes. I like mercantilism. You know what this province reminds me over here? What is it? Kiwasim? It reminds me of Kemlingrad, I think it is. The exclave of Russia. That's what it reminds me of. Just from a map standpoint. But Sai. Maybe. Who is Pasai allied with? They are over. Are you still allied with Ming? You are, you son of a bitch. Okay. See, I don't know if that's just something with the patch or something, but these guys do not lose alliances at all. Maybe they improved at 1.16, but I don't know. Oh, sweet, we're getting close now. Making that money. What are we making off of Indus? Okay, yeah, we're making a little bit more. We were making 0.08 ducats before. Now we're making 0.38. So, you know, it's an increase. Helping us keep afloat with our nice little empire here. Disputed succession. Chile. Move this way. Alright, what is their provincial press? Okay, well, yeah, it's still negative. Let's boost our prestige. Stability. Yeah, man, I'm gonna boost our prestige. Yeah, we're just gonna go to the cocktail parties and it'll be great. Yikes. That's a bitch. Growth of admin. Okay. With great pedigree comes great ability. It is true, we do need self-made men. No, the nobles are like, how dare you, you son of a bitch! And I'm like, calm down, just. Influence. They don't have a lot of influence. Well, they do, but I Conquistador. That one might be nice, actually. As long as it's under 80, right? Yeah, as long as it's under 80, we're fine. Ooh, yeah, it was worth it, man. It was totally worth it. Also, let's give them the nobles some stuff, so they don't get too hasty on us. It's overseas, so it has to be in native lands. There you go, nobles. There you go. Are you happy now? Those bastards. Well, we're gonna trade embargo you two, Zappa. Ah, shit. Okay. Let's do a trade embargo against them. Where is it? Trade embargo. Yeah. Oh, they're not my rivals. Okay. Tapa, Timbuktu. I don't want. Australia. Oh, Japan's a nation. Nice. That's an impressive navy. How do I get their influence down? Well, I could probably do something. Okay. I'll keep my eye on it. Is there any country that wants to work with us? Sins. What do they not like? It's different religions. Okay. Bengal would be a really nice ally, but I don't. Oh my god, they're allied with the Ottomans. Jeez. Portugal, how about us? Would you like to work on something? Oh boy, fun. Now we run our armies the hell away. Just go somewhere. Just run. Whatever you do, just run. At least we have a fort blocking the way. They can't move out. What? What? There's a fort there, you... Oh. There's a fort there, bro. You tripping. Man, you just... Oh my god. Just... Yeah. Alright, well... GG for those guys. They're gonna die. Let's do it that way. Just don't give them the privilege. Well, let's run the hell away then. There we go. Yeah, the Ottomans are gonna keep doing this. That. We're gonna try to delay this war as long as possible so that look at that, that's just That's just too OP. Look at this. Look at this. How many forts is that? What is that? If I could see, damn it. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So they have over 25 forts, at least. Not to mention if they have any overseas provinces. Good lord. It's too OP. If we can keep this war on long enough, for at least into the mid-20s, they're not going to be able to declare war for like another 15 years. And basically, we'll get a slight boost to our income due to revanchism. And how can I stop this? Oh, I just need to make the nobles not worth anything. Okay, so basically, there we go, solved that issue. I don't care what you think, boy. You ain't taking my shit. Our goal right now is just to keep what we have and end the game. Bankruptcy looming. How? Oh, it's because they have their provinces. Okay. Well, hi, Warsengali. How are you? You're having some fun there. So what I've learned from this campaign, make sure to invade the Mamluks as quickly as possible, and if you can, try to stop the Ottomans. Next campaign I'm probably going to play in Europe though, just to try out the new maritime ideas and stuff. I heard they're pretty interesting. Look at that 46 static. We are bankrupt. Ah, fun. They destroy all my armies. No, they didn't. Well, that's good at least. Like, we hate you. It's very tempting to quit this early, but I'm going to see it to the way through. Just let it run. I moved my computer to a different spot, so perhaps it's not as loud. I kept it in a small area, so that's probably why a lot of the heat was generated. Although, I can kind of hear it now, so hopefully it's not as bad. Trying to figure this all out, you know. At least the Ottomans will take care of our rebels, I think, won't they? Unless it's a 30 stack, and I need to run the hell away. Get the hell out of there, because this is... Yeah, what really screwed us up was we had a leader for about 70 to 80 years that was a 010, and that really screws you up. move these guys upwards. Oh shit, it's an island. I can't. Alright, no, it's such low maintenance, I can't. Why are they still locked? There we go. Okay, it's RP steel from the Ottomans, whatever they want. What'll they take? I didn't even notice. Oh boy, look at that. Just beautiful, isn't it? Oh boy. Yeah, you know, earlier in the game I said, oh, well, this isn't that bad, you know, and just, you know, it happens. We did some success. I can honestly say that we failed. And that's okay, though, because failing is part of the process. It's okay. Failing is part of the process, after all. Get some more guys so I can fight these assholes off. Oh yeah, I'm still at war with Sengali. Ah, my neglect. I need the taxes. Go this way, yes. Oh, they're trapped. Oh no. Move these boats up here. What, do the pirates only go after the Western nations?
I'm offended.
Alright, move them here. No. Did I say you could do that? No. I'm gonna move the boats here. You are going to produce some guys over here, and we are going to move our guys here. There you go. Parallel authority. Keep them there. Produce another guy. That's the plan. Keep them there in Lanao. I like how we can afford to do stuff now. It's pretty fun. go here. Push them into a corner. Okay, what's the mission we can do? Keep going against them, losing the turf. They're gonna have to cross a river in order to fight us. That's what I like. Whatever you want, man. Oh, we paid them too? Oh, you guys are... Oh, you were something that I just... I'm not going to say it on here, but you guys are bad people. So why not? Ah, right. We're gonna take a loan. Place my army there. Siege it pretty quick. Moving over there. Well, we don't have any legitimacy to begin with. See, that's why allies are super important in this game. Whoa, 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 wait a minute! Whoa! Hold on just a moment. What the f... Huh? Okay, so I attacked them. Did anybody see that? They had no morale. I have no idea why not. That is a load of bullshit. Yes, see? Full morale. See? Full morale. What, did it not register as full morale? I mean, it is a possibility. Alright, I'm gonna go squish them now. See why? Please. I have enough soldiers, don't I? I'm just getting annihilated. Why? Yeah, see, I have clearly the enough ratio. Why am I getting my ass beat so bad? I'm gonna attack them again just to see what's up. Maybe it's just the ratio of troops. Okay, so why? Okay. Morale, current maximum Y. I don't get it. How strange. See, I just don't understand. I really don't. Like,
what's happening?
I know the clock's still going, I'm aware. Yeah, siege ability, of course. Okay, now it works. The hell? That was really strange. And I'm glad I recorded it, because it doesn't look like I'm telling a fib. Yeah, let's move here. That sounded really cheesy, like cat in the house kind of shit. As long as I'm not telling a fib, it is okay. Good lord. Oh, look, we got metallurgy. We don't even have universities, good lord. We're very primitive, our country is, in this game. Just a streak of bad luck, essentially. Washik. Yo, man, I'm from Washik. In a different timeline, the country of Ethiopia is now centered in a small island called the Philippines. The African culture made a mass exodus after the Ottomans took over most of the world. Talk about a world conquest of epic proportions. Okay, nobles, they don't like us. They're like, hey, you, we don't like you. Yes, you. We have more land over in Asia. Our continent should switch. Nope, because it's overseas. Oh boy. Oh lovely, this is getting excuse me. Anyway, I can make this any faster. See, this is a time where I use copyright-free music and just play it over this. Just listen to the beauty as we watch our nation continue into the long abyss. You know, I'm very impressed with Paradox. I'm glad that they release DLC so frequently. Although, I wish they would have came out with, like, a season pass or something, because, I mean, paying, what is it, $15 a pop per DLC, whether there's been, like, six of them, right? It's, like, it's kind of rough, but, I mean, maybe if they, I don't know, made a season pass or something, it'd be a lot more worth it. They're probably going to still be making DLC for at least another year, I'm pretty sure, which is, pretty amazing since this game's been out since 2013, and most games that are in that age bracket, the companies just don't care. They made their money and they decided, you know what, we're gonna do our next game, or they just got tired of producing for it. So I'm gonna say they more made their money and ran away, because that's what business is about. Make the most money as you can and screw the customer. That's what it boils down to. You can spruce it up as much as you want, but I mean, that's why I prefer smaller places, like mom and pop's place. But you know, it's diving a little bit into politics, so we're gonna refrain from speaking of such things. But hello, Mr. Pirate, how you doing? Oh, he's running away. He's got his loot and he's getting his booty. Might as well harsh treatment. Yeah, let's just take a look at the world, since we don't have a lot going on. These are the trade routes. Very interesting stuff. I think Japan's independent. Let's take a look at their stuff. Yes, they're their own country. Excellent. These guys haven't done a lot. Delhi's big. All the way into Iran. Bengal is all the way up into China, which that'd be interesting to see a war between those two. And then you got the Ottomans, they got the Middle East in this area. Tunis, look at that, they're just ginormous. In Northern Europe, we have Scandinavia, the Commonwealth. Brandenburg is becoming the new HRE. Then we got Great Britain, they're doing alright. France is getting bigger. They got this part of Africa. Timbuktu still exists. Congo. I'm surprised the Europeans haven't gone after these West African nations. Who's controlling that? Is that Florence? Or Aragon? That's Aragon. Aragon still exists in this game. And this is Hungarian Italy. Very strange game. Also, up until about, I don't know, 50 years ago, Ragusa was still a very large country. They were controlling about this, and I had never seen that before until the Ottomans came and just kind of shat on their parade. That kind of happens with the Ottomans. They see something you love, and they just crush it to death. Pacifico Norte. What nation is that? Spain, huh? Nice, good job, Spain. Spanish Alaska, French Canada, Newfoundland. Okay, it doesn't look that much difference. Although you got the Dutch that are the Flemish down here, which I mean, the Dutch did settle New York. and they called it New Amsterdam, I think New York City was called, Florida, Timbuktu. Oh, well, there you go. The 13 colonies, New Flanders, death of the merchants, I'll take the money. Louisiana, that's his own thing. Mexico is his own thing, so good job for Mexico. Portugal is controls Oregon, California, in this area, nice job. Tunisian Colombia, well, look at you, Tunis, you even got colonies, good for you. France got the Antilles, look at that. They did a good job taking all that over and not having to compete. Those are good spice islands, and, or not spice islands, but they got stuff there. I think it's just random goods, chocolate, vanilla, that kind of thing. Brazilian La Plata, New Castile, Chile, British Brazil. That's different. So yeah, the world's a little strange in this game.
We basically didn't mingle with Europe.
So, I can't wait to see how I play Europe next one. I think it'll be very interesting. I can't wait to dominate some of these cats. Like Australia, you're gonna get a piece of my mind. And Austria, there you go. The end game, I believe, is 1814. So, we'll make it to them, and yeah, that'll be fantastic. Mutapa and Ottomans, please fight, because I'd love to see Mutapa just get wrecked. That'd be amazing. Pagarion. Is that how you say it? Pagarion. Pagarion. I tried. Kutai. That's probably gonna flip soon. Dude, see, we got our quaint little Indonesia. Yeah, that, you know, that's one thing I never understood is, even in EU3, they would never call the Philippines by their name. They would just call it, they wouldn't let you colonize it in 3, and in 4, it was Ethiopian Indonesia. No, this is the Philippines. Like, what do you have against that country? You know? It's like, I mean, you took all this time to name Ming, India, and all that crap, but then you got, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, sure, why not? Do we have any loans to pay off, by the way? I think we do. Only 3. Cottage industry. Here you go. Missions. Reclaim Ogaden. Alright. Let's give us some sort of pride in, you know? Yemeni separatists. Oh, I don't care. Yeah, go ahead. Go nuts with that one. Let me see what the Ottomans want. They still want my land, don't they? They're just like, we want to eat it all. Yum, 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 yum. Oh, they want Sula, huh? Well, you can take it from my left ass cheek. you know. They're like, you know what? We feel like we should take your land that's way the hell over here. Because you deserve to kick in the pants. Oh, is this a new nation? I think it is. Trinante. I see. Yeah, you colonize that for me. I'm gonna just steal it. Where are you friends with? Ooh, well, I don't like that. I don't like that at all. I'm sure we take Visaya. Declare war. Oh, man. Cotra. Ah, you want that? Well, I actually like that island, so, you know, we're just gonna... We're just not gonna... Well, we can't do anything. Well, good garlic. I think I'm just gonna record the rest of this in one sitting and just upload it in a couple parts. Because there's not a lot going on here, to be perfectly honest. I mean, I could lie and say this is some exciting adventure and... But nah, I don't think I'll do that. I wonder what could be this giant thing off the coast of my country. Excuse me. I wonder what it could be. Straight up. Noble rebels are like, how dare you? Look at that 33 stack. I'm glad I don't have to do it. Oh, is it really Ethiopian peasants? Ah, fun. Fun. Oh, we're over our manpower limit too. Shit, that sucks. Well, okay, so basically... Stability. Alright, let's just let that go on. No, we're not gonna have that happen. If they just wanted the land, I'd give it to them, but... Actually, do I still have a, problem with them? I declare on them just to take the colony. Yes. They would all team up against me. Since I'm such a bad murdering human. Oh, Ottomans, you're so funny. You're just like the British. Oh yeah, no, we're not the enemies. It's the local tribe that your problem, yeah. Castilian Papua. Yeah, the colonies is what is bankrupting us right now. We don't have any prestige anyways. Well, I need war taxes. I forgot about that. So we're 80 years left. Let's look at the terrain. What an interesting terrain. I'm impressed with the kind of detail they do, especially this. It's quite nice. You can even see the seasons changing, and it's quite lovely. They're merely crying. Wonder how Japan's doing, just in the rankings. They haven't really made any tutorial games besides... Oh, Ryukyu's still independent. Actually, could I just do a quick war on them? Probably could. Can I fabricate on them? Should be able to. Why not? I'm bordering them in the closest possible, except for Taiwan, but... Oh yeah, it's not sticking on the sea tile, that's why. Okay. Just start colonizing Japan. That would be interesting, that's for sure. Look at all these islands. Portugal's got them. Oh, nice. The Yap Islands. Yappity yep. You know, I wonder on the new DLC if now it's going to give Portugal a better chance against Castile, since it's more trade-based. Allegedly. And if I remember correctly, I believe Portugal invests a lot more in its navy than it did its army. I don't know if that's 100% true, but I think that would make sense, because Portugal's not a huge nation, so it wouldn't make sense for them to have a long-standing army. That's for sure. That's for certain. 1 second. Revolts. Okay, well, we better do something. What about my army? Are they at full? Basically, yes. See, now the armies are normal. I get it. Come on, roll better, roll better. There you go. Raise the war taxes. Excellent. Make that money. internal conflicts. Hey, maybe that'll give us a chance to make a move. No, they're still allied with me. Let me actually do anything. Ooh, actually, this might be a very good opportunity. We don't have a way to fabricate it. What about Kutai? Who are you allied with? What kind of military do you have? Or, I should go to the ledger, excuse me. You got about 30,000 troops. Okay. They're a protectorate, damn. I could do no CB and attack them. But do I really want to do that? We'll wait till this first war is over with, though. Come on, War Sengali, just take the rest of the land and you're gonna have fun getting killed by Mutapa. Oh, I'm at war with Mutapa, actually. Oh. Whoops. It's like, we're gonna declare war because stuff. Alright, wait a minute. Portugal, would you want an alliance, maybe? No. Ning has some pretty extreme death. Oh, look at that! It's happening, guys! There you go, Bengal. You go. You kick some butt. So we have one province here. Ah. Lovely. Oh, that sucks. We do have some of these islands over here. Capital's over here now. Sweet. I love it. There we go. Civil War. When is my king gonna die anyways? At least 52. See, we got all the good leaders at the end. I don't know why it's firing now. I think it's because we were at war. Yeah. There you go, Yon. Good for you. Let's see if we can boost the stability here, reduce. Nah, I'm good. See, you know, if we started with a uniformed religion country and just uniform culture like this is, we'd probably do far better. It's just, Ethiopia starts with a bunch of area that you just can't go through since they're all Sunni. They're not the same religion. Look at that, they're fighting over Taiwan. This is a very strange game right now. Okay, guys, well, I'm thinking about doing this, the rest of this in the second sitting. Thanks for watching, everybody. Sorry we didn't have a successful campaign, but, you know, shit happens, right? Alright, thanks for watching. Have a nice one.